Fora TV, the world is thinking.
So originally when we started, we were literally sending clunky big video cameras all over the world to empower people. And these were, at the time, I think $2,000. Now, flip cameras, which are these small, handy little cameras, can be in the hands of anybody. So really what is making this possible is the advance of technology. And these are the cameras that we actually train human rights defenders with. In addition to that, which is obviously originally was a little bit our dream when this organization was started, people now have mobile phones in their hands and anybody can become a witness to a human rights violation and can upload this or can do something with that footage. And as I like to say, we are creating a whole next generation of human rights defenders. So technology has had a very key major influence, but again, not just in terms of that technology, these images showing up on the web in front of a big population, but across the board in different places. So the trends that we're seeing is obviously there's a lot more accessibility, there's much more participation in the sense that because new platforms are coming up, like YouTube or other places, people can organize themselves online and there's a community building to actually create change. On the one hand, that creates better global accountability, but on the other hand, the people who occupy these spaces are much more transitory, so that poses a bit of an issue. It's much more mobile because you don't literally, I think it's a billion people who are gonna have video-equipped cell phones in their hands this year. And all in all, people have become much more literate around the use of media. So we work not with video professionals predominantly, but with community organizers or concerned citizens who really would like to, who are in places where they can actually have an influence. Seeing these trends about a year ago, we created a platform where people could upload media and create that community around human rights violations, which is called the Hub. So the notion there is that there was really a need for a safe and secure platform that was standing apart, where people can upload, share, view, create community, create groups. We've done that very much in collaboration with a number of other human rights groups, but anybody who has human rights video can actually upload and find their community there. It was also very important that that space was a safe and secure space. We believe that the storytelling around this is very important. If you watch a video on YouTube, where we, by the way, also have a channel, you may see a blogger and you may see police brutality happening against that person, but it doesn't always give you the context and tell you exactly what's happening. Neither does it actually give you the space to take action. So what we really try to do with this website is either through blog posts or other places contextualize what's going on in this particular video and create the space to take action. This is what it looks like. The particular campaign that you see here is that we trained a group called Likado who works with community organizers in Cambodia where they're working on issues of forced eviction. So what's also very important that in real time now these human rights violations are being documented, because very often things happen after the fact, but in this case, the community organizers can really be there, document, and create a record so that later on they can actually make their case against the authorities and the people who are actually perpetrating these crimes.